Good morning and welcome to Weekly Insights with John Plassard. With the global population continuing to expand, the world will need to double its food supply over the next three decades. That's a daunting task, especially as arable land for farming shrinks due to climate change, urban sprawl, and soil destruction. At the current pace, farmland could fall 50% by 2050, making an already daunting challenge even tougher. A new type of agriculture is growing. Vertical farms grow plants on trays stacked in a closed, controlled environment. Efficient LED lighting has made the process cheaper, though energy cost remains a burden. Vertical farms can be located close to customers, reducing transport costs and CO2 emissions. Water use is minimized and bugs are kept out, so no pesticides are needed. In Britain, the Jones Food Company will open the world's largest vertical farm, covering more than 13,000 square meters in 2022. AeroFarms, an American firm, will open its largest vertical farm in Danville, Virginia. Other firms will be expanding too. Nordic Harvest will enlarge its facility just outside Copenhagen and construct a new one in Stockholm. Plenty, based in California, will open a new indoor farm near Los Angeles. Vertical farms mostly grow high-value leafy greens and herbs, but some are venturing into tomatoes, peppers, and berries. The challenge now is to make the economics stack up too. Given the dependence of many countries on Russian foodstuffs, for example, this could prove to be an extraordinary alternative. Do not hesitate to ask us for more information about this type of companies. Thank you very much. Have a great week and keep on winning.